Okay, good. Next.
So I hide that sun from your face.
We got sun there. There's like 1,000 gnats.
All right, 1, 2, 3. Oh, sunglasses off.
Oh shit.
Kitty,
come on, coach.
Hey, what are you doing?
Meow.
He wants to be in the picture.
Sit right there and look at
him. That's actually hilarious. He's going towards Derek.
You see it?
There he goes.
What? Look anywhere but me.
Jeez. Oh, yeah.
Yep.
Oh, yeah.
Hands up, pucker
up. Ow.
Hands up, pucker up.
Look at all those.
All that sweat.
Look at all those bugs. All the sweat.
Oh, yeah.
Alright, 1, 2, 3. I'm getting all the bugs in the
book. Oh my god.
He's so allergic.
Oh no.
He's like, no.
Holy
cat.
Oh my god.
Is that okay?
Yeah. I mean, whatever.
Alright, I guess it's just do one with the dudes.
Oh my god.
Really? That's
right. Eyes in the groom. Just do your thing. Pretend we're not here. But Mike and Liz look at each other, noses touch.
Oh, yeah.
Do we smile?
Yeah, cool.
Right there. He's looking for me.
Yeah.
Are you guys doing a little kiss? 1, 2, 3.
Nice.
All rise.
Thank you.
ask couples who have a strong and abiding love what they like most about their partners. Many will say when they are with that person, they don't have to pretend to be anything other than what they are. They're able to express themselves without fear or being judged or rejected. There's room in the relationship for both of them to be unique individuals. They are free to surrender to the vulnerability of true intimacy, to be known and loved unconditionally. At this time, Marissa and Mike would like to take a moment to honor those loved ones who are not with us today. Please let us take a moment of silence. Now we have asked two family members to present a reading of Promises of Love. Dina.
You've known each other from the first glance of acquaintance to the point of commitment. At some point, you decided to marry. From that point of yes to this moment of yes, indeed, you have been making promises and agreements in an informal way. All those conversations that were held riding in a car, over a meal, or during long walks, all those sentences that began with, when we're married, and continued with, I will, and you will, and we will. Those late night talks that included someday, and somehow, and maybe. And all those promises that are unspoken matters of the heart. All these common things and more are the real process of a wedding. The symbolic vows that are about to make are a way of saying to one another, you know, all those things we promised and hoped and dreamed? Well, I meant it all, every word. Look at one another and remember this moment in time. Before this moment, you have been many things to each other: acquaintance, friend, companion, lover, dancing partner, and even teacher, for we have learned much from each other in the last few years. Now you should say a few words that take you across a threshold of life, and things will never quite be the same between you. For after these vows, you shall say to the word, this is my husband, this is my wife.
I am also honored to have been chosen by my niece and my new nephew. May you have the love only two can know. May you go where only two as one may go. May the sun rise and set in your bonded hearts, and the moon never find you too long apart. May you cherish each other's dreams as your own, and turn stumbling blocks into stepping stones. May you brave life's mountains and miles together. May there be no storm your love cannot weather. May you be lovers and allies and friends. May your soul's conversations never end. May you capture on earth what's in heaven above. May your hearts know the rapture of an uncommon love.
Today we remember that a wedding is a heartfelt and meaningful symbol. The ceremony is not magic. It will not create a relationship that does not exist already and has not already been celebrated, all the commitments Marissa and Micah made to each other, both large and small, in the days since they first met. What we are celebrating today is not the beginning of a marriage, but a marriage already in progress. This ceremony is a symbol of how far they have come together symbol of the promises that will continue to make each other throughout their lives. Nothing is easier than standing here and saying these words. And nothing is more difficult than living them day to day. When you love somebody, you don't love them all the time in exactly the same way. That is impossible. Yet that is what most of us expect. We forget the ebb and flow of life and love and of relationships. We insist on permanence, on duration, on continuity. But in love, as in life, the only stability is in change, in growth, and in freedom. Therefore, what you promise today must be renewed and reaffirmed tomorrow and all tomorrows to come. I've considered all of this. Mike, do you promise to do your very best each day to create a loving, healthy, and happy marriage?
I do.
Marissa, do you promise to do your very best each day to create a loving, healthy, and happy marriage?
I do.
Mike, please take Marissa's hand and repeat after me. I take you as you are.
I take you as you are.
Loving who you are.
Loving who you are.
I promise from this day forward.
I promise from this day forward.
To be grateful for our love and our life.
To be grateful for our love and our life.
To be generous with my time, my energy, and my affection.
To be generous with my time, my energy, and my affection.
To be patient with you and with myself.
To be very patient with you and with myself.
To fill our life with adventure and our home with laughter.
To fill our life with adventure and our home with laughter.
To inspire you to grow as an individual.
To inspire you to grow as an individual.
And to love you completely.
And to love you completely.
These things I pledge to you.
These things I pledge to you.
Marissa, repeat after me. I take you as you are.
I take you as you are.
Loving who you are.
Loving who you are.
I promise from this day forward.
I promise from this day forward.
To be grateful for our love and our life.
To be grateful for our love and our life.
To be generous with my time, my energy, and my affection.
To be generous with my time, my energy, and my affection.
To be patient with you.
To be extremely patient with you.
And with myself.
And with myself.
To fill our life with adventure and our home with laughter.
To fill our life with adventure and our home with laughter.
To inspire you to grow as an individual.
To inspire you to grow as an individual.
And to love you completely.
And to love you completely.
These things I pledge to you.
These things I pledge to you.
Please take a good look at your partner's hands. So you may now see the gift that they are to you. These are the hands of your best friend that are holding yours on your wedding day. These are the hands that will work alongside yours as together you build your future. These are the hands that, when wrinkled and aged, will still be reaching for yours. Your wedding ring is a symbol of your promise to one another. The ring, an unbroken, never-ending circle, is a symbol of committed, unsending love. Place this ring on Marissa's finger. Take these words after. I take you now and for always is always now.
I take you now and always, for always is always now.
Marissa, as you place this ring on Mike's finger, repeat these words after me. I take you for now and for always is always now.
I take you now and for always is always now.
Marissa and Mike, you've come here today on your own free will. The presence of family and friends have declared your love and commitment to each other. You have exchanged rings as a symbol of your promises to one another, which will be kept in all the days and years to come. By the power of your love and commitment to each other, and by power invested in me by the state of Massachusetts, now my honor and delight to declare you husband and wife. You now share your first kiss as husband and wife.
You guys enjoying tonight?
Yes!
Let's start with Donna and Steve Kalikia, the father and mother of their groom. They're going to be coming up from right above you guys, right down from the staircase. The mother and father of the groom. Up next, we have Carol James. And we also have Weston with her. She is the mother of the bride, everyone. Miss Carol Tange, little Weston with her. Up next, we have Alan and Linda Tange, the father and stepmother of the bride. Up next, we have Lindsay and Matt. Next we have Colleen and Alex.
I.
Next we have Carlene and Pedro.
I'll tell y'all, having a good time.
Up next, we have Kayla and Derek.
Somebody once told me the world is gonna roll me. I ain't the sharpest tool in the shed. She was looking kind of dumb with her finger and her thumb and the shape of an L on her forehead. Well, the years start coming and they don't stop coming. Fed to the rules and I hit the ground running. Didn't make sense not to live for fun. Your brain gets smart, but your head gets dumb. So much to do, so much to see, so much wrong with taking the back street.
Up next, ladies and gentlemen, we have Melissa and Steve, the maid of honor and the best man.
I got this feeling inside my bones. It goes electric, baby, when I turn it on. Off from my city, off from my home. We're flying up, no ceiling when we in our zone. I got that sunshine in my pocket. We got that good soul in my feet. I feel that hot blood in my body.
And last but not least, ladies and gentlemen, for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Michael and Marissa Colicchio!
It's a beautiful night, we're looking for something dumb to do. Hey, baby.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mike and Marissa would like to share their first dance with you.
Thank you.
Gentlemen, Mr. and Mrs. Michael and Marissa Kulikia.
How's everyone doing tonight? Nice day. Glad we had no rain. Thankfully, it held off. I just want to first thank everyone for joining us on this special day. I'd like to thank my parents for everything they've been able to do with me and my brother, and everything they've had to go through and during our, growing up phases. For those of you who don't know me, I am Mike's twin brother, Steve. Yeah. Growing up twins, people never seemed to believe we were telling the truth. I guess I can't blame them, as we were quite the opposites growing up. Mike with his brown hair, brown eyes, me with my blondish hair, blue eyes. I was always very into sports, and he would rather play video games or read a book. Once we would get past all our disparities between people, when we were telling them that we were twins, people would always want to know, who was born first? Well, it was me. By 4 minutes. God bless you, Mom. So I guess that would technically make me the older brother. But the truth is, I always looked to Mike growing up. He always seemed to do everything first, and then I followed. I never started doing well in school until I saw my brother pulling down straight A's. He was the first to have a girlfriend. He was the first to get a car. He was the first to get a job, and later a full-time job. He was the first to move out and be on his own. And now, he's the first to get married. And Mike, I know this isn't the first time. I don't know where you are right now. Oh, I love you, bro. And Marissa, I always have to remember that Marissa is spelt with one S. I remember when Mike and Marissa first started dating. It had been the first time he had started getting serious with a girl in a while. So I wasn't exactly sure what to think at first. It quickly became apparent that she was very different. She fit in well perfectly with our entire family. The way she interacted with my Nana and my mom was incredible. And we couldn't have asked for a better addition to the family. Mike and Marissa, you have exactly what you need to live happily with each other. Compromise, trust, and respect. So here's to Mike and Marissa, and to the next chapter. Thank you.
Hi, everyone. My sincerest thanks go out to Mike and Marissa for having me be here by your side today. I also want to express much love and gratitude to Marissa and Mike's families for bringing such lovely people into this world. As many of you know, Marissa and I have known each other since we were just a few months old. A beautiful thing about knowing someone your whole life is that there are countless moments to share together in joy, sadness, and pride, and countless opportunities to be excited for each other. Today stands out as one of the brightest. I distinctly remember Marissa and I playing wedding when we were 6 years old, taking turns as bride and flower girl, walking up and down the kitchen hallway in my parents' home, tossing styrofoam packing peanuts as flower petals. I warmly remember afternoons spent trying so hard to climb the giant rock in the Tainch's backyard, coloring our arms with chalk tattoos, and eating our weight in Triscuits and cheese. We sang too many emo songs in my car and got dolled up for prom together, much like we did today. And we were there for each other when we lost our beloved grandparents, who I know are close by tonight. And we were there to celebrate all the milestones, graduations, new jobs, and even moving across the country. Growing up with two older brothers, Marissa was my sister. I remember being in New Hampshire with Marissa the weekend after her and Mike really hit it off. Sitting by the pond with the shark rock, I could see her light up as she was talking about this person. Her excitement was palpable then, and her excitement is palpable now to be married to this man. Something that has always struck me about Mike and Marissa's relationship is the lack of conflict. Yes, they certainly challenge each other and disagree, as you should in healthy relationships, but overall, it's in the most harmonious of ways, grounded with their love to fall back on. A key role of friends is support in relationships and dating, answering SOS calls during a fight and showing up with hugs and wine when things aren't going so well. This has never been needed with Mike. Mike, I love seeing how much you love Marissa. I could not ask for more for her, and I feel certain that you've helped each other to be the best versions of yourself. Thank you for making her dreams come true. Just make sure she gets a dog soon, okay? So while it's hard to believe we're as old as we are, that prom was 12 years ago, and that we can no longer eat infinite amounts of Triscuits and cheese without our pants getting too tight, it's easy for me to believe that today was not just playing wedding in my parents' kitchen, because Mike and Marissa's love is so very real. You too, stay grounded, stay honest, and stay true as you start the greatest adventure of them all. Congratulations, and I love you. Cheers.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, dinner will be served pretty shortly, so hang tight. We'll be back later. Don't you worry. Direct your attention to the center of the room. Mike and Marissa are going to cut their cake.
I've been trying to do it right. I've been living a lonely life. I've been sleeping here instead. Sleeping in my bed, sleeping in my bed. So show me family, all the blood that I will bleed. I don't know where I belong, I don't know where I went wrong. But I can write a song. I belong. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mike would like to invite his mother up.
I hope the days come easy and the moments pass slow, and each road leads you where you wanna go. And if you're faced with a choice and you have to choose, I hope you choose the one that means the most to you. And if one door opens to another door closed, I hope you keep on walking till you find the window. If it's cold outside, show the world the warmth of your smile. But more than anything, more than anything, my wish for you is that this life becomes all that you wanted to. Your dreams stay big, your worries stay small. You never need to carry more than you can hold. And while you're out there getting where you're getting to, I hope you know somebody loves you and wants the same thing. But you never forget all the ones who love you in the place you left. I hope you always forgive and you never regret, and you help somebody every chance you get. Oh, you find God's grace in every mistake, and always give more than you take. But more than anything, yeah, more than anything,
Mike and his mother. Up next, we would like to have Marissa and her father.
Just once upon yesterday, I held you in my arms. You grew into a little girl with lovely childhood charms. Now it seems I only turned around and I see you by his side. Oh, I can't believe my eyes today, my daughter is a bride. Somehow I always knew this day would soon be here. Still I wonder as I look at you, what became of all the years? And no words could ever quite express the way I feel inside. Oh, I can't believe my eyes today, my daughter is a bride. has come to send you on your way. So I wish you every happiness and the blessings of this day. And I hope the love I've given you will forever be your guide. Oh, I can't believe my eyes today. My daughter, oh, I can't believe my eyes. My daughter, oh, my angel and my pride. My daughter is a bride. Oh, I can't believe my eyes. No, I can't believe my eyes. No, I can't.
Ladies and gentlemen, Marissa and her father. Next, dessert will be served, and the dance floor is open.
looks like I'm 5 years old.
Did you get that, Stoney?
I just got in.
No, it's all right. You're good. You're good. You're good.
I was in the line of sight.
You're good. You're good. You're good.
It took a long time. I was there like,
You're good.
Like, I had to, I licked each pen like 4 times.
I love the part where she was trying to write children.
Yeah, we were all, it was like a good fashion.
One, two,
three. Oh, hold on. Why she do it?
One, two, three.
Oh, do that. Yes, I love it. Yes. Oh my God, how beautiful. Don is like that.
You can rally,
Side's a little empty.
All right.
Oh, yeah, a little balanced out.
Ashley? Oh, sorry. Yeah.
There we go.
Wife! Oh, they got married a month ago.
Thanks for hiring me, by the way.
Jokes.
One, two, three. One, two, three. Perfect.
Thank you, guys.
Kiss her, Mike. Yeah.
All right, guys, on three. Look right at me.
Smile.
One, two, three.
Rolling
in
the
picture.
Look at that baby. Oh, my God.
It's just the only chord voice.
Look at that baby.
You guys do a little kiss and everybody in the back go, woohoo.
Okay. One, two, three, go.